So guys, in this video we are going to be testing new makeup products by Essence. We have a whole new collection. It is called Wanna Be My Honey and all of the products have this beautiful beehive design. It is so pretty. In this video I'm also gonna use some of my favorite products by Essence. They are new releases as well, like the Bye Bye Panda Eyes Smudge Proof Mascara and also the My Skin Perfector Loose Fixing Powder. The Insta Perfect Liquid Makeup is one of my favorite foundations, and also the Camouflage Matte Concealer by Essence. Let's start with the 8 products of this Wanna Be My Honey collection. All of the products are inspired by bees, but they are vegan and cruelty free. They don't contain any honey. This one here is a set of makeup remover pads. They are eco-friendly. You can wash them and reuse them as many times as you want. And you can use only water with these makeup pads. I'm very curious to see if they can actually remove any makeup, and I'm gonna use these at the end of this video. I'm so happy. I really wanna see if they are soft enough for my dry and sensitive skin. This is such a cool product. I think they also have another set with 10 items. This one here has 3 makeup remover pads, and let's see how they look, because you don't see in the box. And it is so adorable. I like that we have the honey color. Also, it is like a beehive. It looks very soft and durable. We're gonna check that. In this collection, we also have a luminizing primer. The packaging is super, super pretty. We have a glass bottle, also a pump. It is gorgeous and it says that it contains reflecting gold flakes. Oh, I'm so excited about this, and oh my god, it smells like honey. It smells very nice. Good stuff. For this one here, I'm gonna do a wear test as well. At the end of this video, you can see how it looks. We also have the All Over Balm with natural oils. You can use this one in any dry areas, on your elbows, hands, or your face. I don't have another similar product to this, so I really want to see if it is thick, sticky, or very nice on the skin. Oh my god, this one smells amazing as well. And as you can see, I also wore a t-shirt today in the same color, not exactly the same. And this balm contains shea butter and vitamin E to nourish your skin. Oh, I didn't start with the palette. Who am I? I'm forgetting. We also have this beautiful palette. So, so gorgeous. And it is the eyeshadow and highlighter palette. And in this one, we have 6 eyeshadows and 2 highlighters. These big beehive cells. I like that we have a highlighter for lighter and darker skin tones. And this color story is totally bee inspired and honey. The little bee here is so, so pretty. In this collection, you can also find a mattifying fixing powder. We have this elastic band here, and when you open it, this is the pressed powder. I don't usually have the best experience with pressed powders, but you never know, we may find the best product today. Who knows? I really like the stamp of the product. It says Be My Honey. We have some brushes in this collection as well, a face brush and also an eyeshadow brush. In a lot of limited edition collections, we have seen these brushes. So if you like this one, you can also get it in this fabulous design and the eyeshadow brush. Moving on to another Wanna Be My Honey product. And this one is the color changing glow lipstick. It looks amazing. This product is for those videos on Instagram that they are cutting the lipstick and they mix it in slime. Oh my god, it smells amazing. So it says that this is color changing, so I'm very curious to see if it is gonna make my lips pink, orange, corally. We have this plastic lip tube, and you can see all the greatness of this lipstick. So it says that we have golden shimmer, but it doesn't say if these are gold flakes. It would be so cool. Water break. So my husband prepared this for me. We have some orange slices, lemon slices, ice cubes and water. It is so refreshing. Let me know in the comments if you have another recipe for refreshing water recipe. Anyways, I'm gonna start off with the All Over Balm. I'm very curious about the consistency. I'm taking a clean spatula here and some of the product. Ooh, it's not so thick. It feels more waxy, and I want to use it on this hand here because on this one I'm gonna do the swatches for the eyeshadow palette. Oh, maybe this is a lot. I'm going to use some on my elbow as well. Ooh, it's very creamy. So this is a very spreadable product. You can see how much I have used here. This is going to last all year long, maybe more. This product can last 6 months, which is crazy because you don't need to use a lot. So the consistency is a little bit thicker and also sticky. So I don't know how well it will work now in the summer. I mean, we don't want to get sticky now. Next, we have this color changing lipstick, glow lipstick. It is not just a lipstick. Oh my god, the scent of these products is incredible. Ooh, I think I see the sparkles. About the color, I think my lips got just a little bit pinkier. I think it doesn't change a lot on me. I'm applying some more color changing lip balms, lipsticks. Always depend on your pH, on your lip pH. It is lightweight, it feels very nice on the lips, and it is very creamy. I'm super excited about the luminizing primer. So let's see how it feels on the skin. Ooh, it looks amazing. It has a very nice consistency. Okay, let's apply some. It has a lightweight formula and it is easy to spread it all over the face. I'm gonna zoom you in. And I also want to apply some on the forehead, this big area here. And you can see a little bit the gold flakes. It feels super nice on the skin. It is a little bit sticky. I think my lips started changing. Let's see if we have any claims on the packaging. Luminizing primer with reflecting gold flakes that spread evenly on the skin. Oh my god, I can't read. Hydrating makeup base with soft honey scent. This one can last up to 12 months and it is made in Italy. So it's not a super illuminating product. I can still see some of the flakes, but I think if you just press them, you can blend them. My pores, I think, are exactly the same as before. I don't think that it is very illuminating, but it doesn't look bad. So let's continue with the foundation. I'm gonna use the Insta Perfect Liquid Makeup and I have it in the shade 40. And with my sponge, I'm gonna take some and I'm starting applying on the perimeter of my face, on the jawline, because I have a lot of veins that I want to cover. And I have done a full day wear test and the review for this foundation. I'm going to have a link in the description box if you want to check it out. A little bit on the forehead as well. For concealer, I'm gonna use the Camouflage Matte Concealer. I have it in the shade 30 Light Honey. With this one, I wanna cover the under eye area, also my eyelids. I'm gonna set everything with this mattifying fixing powder. And I'm going to use this brush here by AOA Studio. This is from the Bamboo collection, I think. Bamboo brush set. And this is $1. So I'm going to take some of this powder and I will try to set my face. I think also the powder has a honey scent. I'm not sure. I'm blending a little bit the creases on my forehead. This powder is translucent. You can use it on any skin tone. I think it sets my foundation. I'm very surprised. I have used again setting powders that are pressed by Essence and I didn't like them, the banana powder. So I'm thinking about not using this one on my eyes. I'm gonna use the fixing powder that I have showed you before, the loose fixing powder, because we also have a new eyeshadow palette. And I want to use something that I have used again, not a new powder. I'm gonna take... Oh my god, my messy bun is the worst today. I'm going to take some pictures. So I think we don't have any flashback. It looks very natural. I don't see any ghost areas. I'm blending lightly the creases on my eyes. And after that, I'm using some powder on top of the concealer with a loose fixing powder in the shade 10 Light. Okay, and next, let's see how the brush is looking. Ooh, it's so pretty. The bristles are super soft. I like that the brush is so well made. No harsh edges. Also, we have the beehive design on the handle. This one here is called highlighter brush, but I like using it for my bronzer and the blush. So I'm gonna use this one here. This is from the collection Bronzed This Way Matte Bronzer, and I have the shade for lighter skin. I have also done a review video for this collection. I'm going to have a link in the description box below. And let's take some with this new brush, the honey brush. And I'm defining a little bit the cheekbone, also the forehead. This one is very similar to the other brushes that I have tried, the highlighter brushes. If you have a smaller forehead, try to stay very close to the hairline and don't try to bring the product in the center of the forehead because you're going to make it even smaller. For a blush, I'm gonna use the blush lighter in the shade Peachy Dawn, and this one has a matte blush and also a highlighter. I'm not gonna use a highlighter today because we have two shades in the palette. You can find this blush in four colors. I have two of them and they are super pretty on the skin, very easy to blend. You can find these blushes in the spring summer collection if you want to try them out. And I'm also using some on the bridge of the nose. The brush is very convenient for blush and bronzer. I think it is very big for highlighting your face. I have just finished with my brows and I have filmed an eyebrow tutorial. So let's continue with the palette and also the eyeshadow brush that we have. We have a plastic layer here. Why? This is always happening to me. I found a hack. Unboxing hack. So let's swatch all of the products first. Ooh, we have yellow based highlighters. And this is the darker highlighter, which is not so noticeable on me because this is not for my skin tone. You can also use both of these as eyeshadows. So I want to try the lighter shade and I'm taking the E40 brush by Sigma and this one here. Ooh, that's a very pretty shade. It is a little bit yellowy. Okay, so I need to blend that out because it looks like a stripe of highlighter. I think this one is going to look very nice for medium skin tones. Also the darker for darker complexions. With the previous brush, I'm blending everything together. Okay, I think you can make it more wearable, but I think it's not very natural on me. I'm also going to use some on my nose to go with the honey theme. It looks smooth and it's not powdery and patchy. So I want to swatch also the eyeshadows, and I'm gonna start with this one here because it is very similar to the highlighter. And this is the highlighter, this is the eyeshadow. The eyeshadow is a little bit more intense, but as you can see, they look very similar. So I think it would be better if we had another matte shade, because as I can see now, we only have two shades. These two here are the matte shades. Let's continue with the swatches and after that we can discuss about the color story some more. I'm taking the matte shades that we have. I think this one is not gonna be noticeable on me. You can use it to highlight your brow bone if you don't like shimmery eyeshadows. You can also use it to set your concealer if this is the shade for you. And I'm also taking the other three eyeshadows. Ooh, this golden one! It's so gorgeous! So these are all of the eyeshadows. Before we start with the eyeshadows, let's see the brush as well. It is super pretty. I think it is a little bit bigger than the regular eyeshadow brushes. Yes. This one actually looks like a shorter, tapered blending brush. Like this one here that I'm using always to contour my nose. I'm going to take a little bit of the highlighter and I'm going to use it on the brow bone. It's very yellow for my skin tone. I'm not gonna apply some more because I think it's very intense. So the bristles of the brush are so soft. It reminds me of the 217 brush by MAC, but with shorter bristles. That was one of my favorite brushes 10 years ago. With the same brush, I'm going to take this yellow shade. This is a very intense color. And I'm going to use this as my transition color in the crease because we don't have any other shade that I can use. The other matte eyeshadow is very light for me. This brush works very well for the outer crease. And the eyeshadow is blended very nicely. It has a very nice color payoff. With another eyeshadow brush by Essence, I'm taking this darker golden bronzy eyeshadow. I'm going to place that on the outer eyelid. I'm also taking some with my fingertip. Ooh, it looks even better. With this eyeshadow, you can have something soft, also something more intense. That's not bad. Here we have this bright yellow gold eyeshadow. I'm going to take some with my eyeshadow brush and I'm going to press it on the inner eyelid. It is a little bit glittery and not very opaque on the eyes. I think I need to press this with my fingertip. So I'm taking some with the ring finger. Ooh, it's very glittery. I have some fallouts from this eyeshadow. So with a clean brush, I'm just wiping away the fallouts. Yes, they are not leaving me. On the other eye, I'm using a sponge tip applicator. You can have a more precise application with a sponge tip, oops, applicator. So if you don't like using your fingertips, you can also use this guy here. I will try to remove the fallouts this time with some powder, not just with the brush. Oh, yeah, it's not happening. This shade is prettier without all of these lights. Look at this. Oh my god, it's so glittery. But it doesn't have micro glitter, or at least I cannot see them, or they are very, very fine micro glitter. After that, I'm taking this light bronzy eyeshadow that looks like the highlighter, and I'm going to smudge this on the outer part of the lower lash line. On the eyes, it's not looking very bronzy. It is like a very light yellowy bronzy eyeshadow. For the other eye, I'm gonna take the highlighter because I'm very curious to see if they look the same on the eyes. They are very similar. However, the eyeshadow is a little bit lighter, you can see that. Now I'm gonna mix them so I can make my eyes the same. I'm taking again this shade here with the same brush and I'm going again over the outer lower lash line. I want to define this a little bit more, but I think I'm not able because all of the shades are very light in color. I look like a honeybee. This palette definitely needs a brown shade or a light beige eyeshadow, because I'm not able to give definition. If you have hooded eyes, you know what I'm saying. Moving on to this light yellow shade. This one looks in the swatches like a satin eyeshadow. It's not very shimmery, also it's not matte. In another palette, I think this eyeshadow would be better, but we have a lot of light yellow eyeshadows in this one. This shade is noticeable on the skin, however, it is also very light. You can always use another eyeshadow palette, of course. I'm always reviewing a color story of a palette based on the palette that I have on my hands, and I'm not using another product. I didn't use this one here, and I'm taking the Eye Blender brush by Essence to pick it up, and I'm just going to use a little bit of this shade in the inner part of my brows. This one has a nice coverage. It's not so noticeable that I have used it. A lot of times I like using light eyeshadows like this one to clean any darker eyeshadows in the inner corner. I'm going to take the yellow shade again with the new eyeshadow brush. I will try to define a little bit more the outer crease. The nice thing with this eyeshadow is that it is blendable and buildable. I think that the formula of these eyeshadows is not very bad. However, I don't like the colors of the eyeshadows. I'm taking a brown eye pencil by Maybelline to define my eye shape. I'm also going to tight line. This is so uncomfortable. And for mascara, I'm gonna use the Bye Bye Panda Eyes. A very small update about the color changing lip balm. It has a very chemical taste. It's not very nice. It's not like the scent. It is like soap for dishes. And as you can see, my lips also got a little bit pinkier. I'm going to see you in a couple of hours with the wear test for the primer. And also we're gonna use a makeup remover pad, so don't go anywhere. Hi guys, it's been 9 hours and let's check the primer. I'm also very excited about the makeup remover pad. I'm gonna zoom you in. Let me find my mirror. Here it is. About the lip balm, for some reason it stained the outline of my lips. About the primer, it didn't crease a lot on my forehead or between my brows. The smile lines are looking fine. It is a little bit glowy, but I mean, it is a luminizing primer. I think it looks very nice. Today was so hot. I like that I don't have any greasy areas of foundation. The coverage of my face products didn't fade. About the eyeshadows, you can see that the colors didn't fade. I have them on my eyes for less hours, but again, they are pretty much the same. It always helps if you use a concealer on your eyes or an eye primer before you apply your eyeshadows. So I think everything looks very nice, and now it's time for the makeup remover pads. I have some water here in this bowl, so let's dip in with one of the makeup removers. Pads! Pads! They are pads! I'm just diving in the water. It can soak up a lot of water. I'm just trying to squeeze the excess off, or I'm not sure. Should I leave it? Oh my god. It's happening! It can remove my brows. No! I was doing them for 8 hours. I'm kidding. It took me just 2 hours. Oh my god, guys, it removes so much makeup. This is so nice. It is very soft on the skin. I want to remove all of my face makeup first, and then I'm going to concentrate on the eyes. Brows, no brows. It removes my brow gel. Do we have any brow hair here? No. We have removed a lot of makeup. So I'm going to change the side. I have water everywhere, but don't worry, I brought my towel. I'm going to remove a little bit of my face makeup just to see. Yes, we have some more. I'm going to soak it up very well, and we're going to the eyes. Oh my god, I was using the label. Disaster. Okay, let's do this again. I'm going to use another one. For me, it's very important to remove my eye makeup with one swipe or with two swipes. I don't want to rub my eyes a lot. I don't really like it for the eyes because I have sensitive eyes, and you can see it started getting red, so I don't really like that, but it can remove a lot of makeup. Let me know in the comments if you have a makeup remover that you can use with pads like this one, so I can use it for my eyes. I don't really like this water technique. Do you want to see what happens with the lips? It removed the residue from the color-changing lip balm. I'm back with some cotton pads just to remove my eye makeup a little bit better. And I'm using the eye makeup remover by Maybelline. And you can see I still have a lot of makeup on my eyes, even though it doesn't look that I have. I'm going to use this one here with my eye makeup remover now. So it's not so easy because this is a very big sponge. I'm going to use another cotton pad with the Milky Tonic by Pixi, and I want to check for one more time and see how much product is left on my face. I have done a 6-week review for these Milky Collection products if you want to check them out, and I'm still using those products. Okay, not a lot of product is left. Let me know in the comments below what is your favorite product of today's video. For me, it's definitely this powder here. My face makeup looked very nice all day long. You can watch next this video here. If you like this one, please give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe and click on the notification bell. And I will see you in the next one. Bye!